reminds me of when we started the chorus over 10 years ago, and we just did our show one night, and we were bringing chairs in from everywhere, and we were making the activity director very nervous because we were way over the fire code. So this just kind of reminds me of that a little bit, so it's just great. So this evening, this is going to be our musical Christmas card to you, our friends and neighbors. And we're going to sing a variety of songs for you. Most of them might be familiar to you. We have two directors this evening, and we're lucky to have three piano players. So you're going to see a bit of people walking around and changing places here. So that song, obviously, was a spiritual. It's kind of interesting. I looked up and it came available in this country in 1865. So now we're going to change and go to a lot more modern song. Mariah Carey has sung this one and made it very popular. Some of you may also know it from the movie Love Actually. And this evening, the solo part will be done by Dawn Nadejic.
All I want for Christmas
"I'll Be Home for Christmas" was originally written to honor soldiers overseas, and it was recorded by Bing Crosby in 1943. And now it's just become a Christmas standard. Kind of interesting, looked up on my friendly computer and said that this song is popular in a lot of countries. Canada, Finland, Australia, Hungary, Netherlands, Portugal, Switzerland, Italy, and the United Kingdom. And recently, more recently, it's been sung by Josh Groban, Kelly Clarkson, Reba McEntire, Michael Bublé, Elvis, Pentatonix, and us. So, it's just a beautiful song, and it has very tight harmony, which means that the chords are, the notes are really close together, so it's kind of a challenge to sing, but it usually turns out to be quite pretty.
And better.
problems in Ukraine. This is a Ukrainian song. It originated in 1914 in Ukraine, and then it spread to other countries. It was introduced to America in a concert at Carnegie Hall in 1922. So this evening we're not going to use piano, but Judy and Sue are going to play the flutes with us.
The storm. and welcome everybody. Ken and Sue have to slip off so that they can get their slippers on. For the dance number, so we'll be doing that shortly. Let's see. Oh, okay. We've been singing for you, and I think it's time that you sing for us.
Yes.
Okay? Now, there's like 4, 5, 6 times as many of you as there are us, so I really expect to hear you. Now, this is a song not a lot of you know, but even if you don't, come along with it. It's Jingle Bells. Okay? So Don is going to play for us. Go for it.
Yeah.
you know, a couple months for a show. It's year-round, getting the music together, getting all the people, breaking down the parts. It's very involved, and they've done a great job. And I'd especially like to thank Harry Newhart. Since 2014, and he's responsible for many creative things such as advertising, making CDs and videos, as well as developing computer-based music aids for us singers. Now what that is he breaks every song down into soprano, alto, tenor, and bass, and he sends us just our part on the internet so we can practice our part without hearing the other ones thrown in there. There's no way we could just learn all of this just coming one day a week for 2 hours, you know, for 3 months. So it's very involved, but everybody here loves it. I also want to thank our stagehands. They've worked so hard here. You know, they've had to move the spots. Bob Masser is our mixer back there with all the sound and everything. Vic Petrelli helped also. Let's see. Our chorus patrons. If you look on the back of your program, you'll notice we have patrons. These are people that have supported us very generously. And due to their generosity, we've been able to afford the piano and, you know, my shoes. but music is very expensive. Most people don't realize, say you have to pay $5 a sheet of music, but you can't photocopy it, so if there's 30 of us, you have to have 30 copies. We have to pay for each and every one. And if you do 12 songs, it adds up. So we just, people have been very generous and we appreciate it. If you notice the patron, tell them thank you. So if you would like to sing, you think you can sing, your neighbors tell you you can't sing, you're welcome to try out. Now try out is, it's very rigorous. You walk in the door and you say, I want to be in the chorus. And that's it. If you answer, you know, yes, then you're good. But we're going to start meeting again, the middle of the month, in January. And you can come any Thursday from 3 to 5 or talk to any member. And try it. If you like it, great. If you don't, that's okay too. I don't read a bit of music. So if you don't read music, don't let that stop. If you like singing, come sing. Okay? That's probably why you heard me off key most of the time. But, you know, they'll say, you know, you're singing a C and not supposed to be a B. And I'll look at them and I go, I'm always going to be flat. So, but they, okay. Now we're going to get back to it. If you guys want to bring out the platform and stuff, then we'll get our director back out here and we'll give you some more good music.
Oh my God!
He's just showing off now, using it too much.
By a woman with very expensive tastes. It was introduced in 1953 by Bertha Kitt, and it's been used in various films and TV shows. It's also been a popular around the globe. And more recently, Taylor Swift and Madonna have recorded it. And we're lucky tonight to have Claudia playing the saxophone with us. And we're not... Yes.
Thank you.
and that's Hanukkah. And I'm told that today is the first day of Hanukkah. This Hanukkah song is really fun to sing. In the middle of the song, there's three different melodies going on at the same time. The sopranos sing one melody by themselves, and then they sing it again, but then the altos join with a different melody. And then the third time around, the tenors and basses join with a third melody. And we also have Sue on the flute for this one, too. Seven key changes.